A deer gave birth to a little one. This little one was laying in the grass, and the mother was looking at her offspring and thought to herself, "You are so pitiful. You can't run fast yet. We have no sharp teeth. We do not know how to fight. So if a lynx, a panther, a wolf is hungry and comes by and catches your scent, it will just come and kill you and eat you. And I can't do anything about it. Or else a man might come by with bow and arrows and shoot you. And I can't help you. This is very, very sad, because then you won't grow up and also have offspring that will carry on the deer nation." She felt very bad standing there looking at her child. But all of a sudden the wind came, but the wind was strange and different. The deer mother thought, "I wonder if this is whatever it is that is powerful. We know that it is there in so many ways. I'm going to just say a prayer and ask it for help." So she addressed it, whatever it is that is powerful. "You see my child here. It is so very helpless, so very pitiful, that it is prey to anything that might want to kill it and eat it, and also can be shot very easily. It can't run fast yet. That is the only thing us deer can do, is run when something comes after us. And I feel so bad that it will never grow up to help the deer nation. So I am asking you if you would help me, some way help my child." And the wind blew and communicated to this deer, "I hear what you have said, and everything you say is true. The deer nation does not have sharp teeth or weapons, do not know how to fight, and your child is even more vulnerable because it has an odor other animals can smell, and it cannot run fast yet. So I will help you, but you have to get something first. You have to get some turnips that have been recently peeled and bring them." So the deer mother went. Somewhere she found some and brought them back. And the wind communicated to her, "Put some by its shoulder, put some along its back, and put some on its rump." So the deer mother laid the turnips on her child's body, the way she was told. And the wind came and blew, and the turnips turned out to be like deer hair, but they kept that whitish color. And the wind blew again on the little deer, and its smell was gone. "There," the wind said, "I have done that. So whenever you see something coming or a hunter, then you can run. And if your little one lays absolutely still and makes no noise, it will not be noticed, and it will live to grow up." So the deer mother was so pleased. She said, "Thank you, thank you, thank you for helping us." So that is how the fawn has its spots and why it has no scent until it grows up.